So when's the next road trip for you?
We're going out for 4th of July weekend to Pismo Beach. Go try out the sand toys, you know, pull out the Kawasaki T-Rex and the quads and stuff like that, and I'll take one of my Jeeps out there that's got a big 450 horsepower motor that can go through sand.
So you put like motorcycles, ATVs in the back of one of the pickups, and then you pull a trailer with the Jeep, or do you
I've got a toy hauler where I can put my quads in it and my Jeep in it, and I've got another truck that's got a box that can put two Jeeps in it and a couple quads and whatnot. So I'm pretty well equipped as far as my toys and stuff.
Now you do a hotel, or you do tents, or what do you do as far as?
I've got an RV trailer that's self-contained. It's got everything in it. Everything that you can think of: shower, bed, DVD player, plasma, TV.
So in other words, you don't rough it,
no.
Albert.
Roughing days are over.
So do you see a lot of people pulling pretty high expensive rigs and stuff and making a spectacle of themselves with it?
Sometimes, yeah.
Oh, I mean, when you go out to these locations in it, you see a lot of people that, you know, might be roughing it, but you see a lot.
Way out stuff. I mean, it's just, you know, $100,000 RV trailers and $300,000 trucks pulling them, and their $500,000 truck inside the trailer. I mean, way out, you know. It's just way out.
Freak show. Have you ever thought of making any back east? Is there any ambition to go to any particular places that are far away?
Not at the moment. I mean, farthest is the Moab, Utah. I mean, I'm going to go out there for next year. I'm going to go out there for Easter Safari and see how that is. Maybe hit the Oregon Dunes, San Luis. They got a lot of good dunes out there in Oregon. Stuff like that, you know, not too far, not too way out.
So any new personal projects for you? Anything you're building that's a different combination than what you already have?
I'm building a 99 TJ. And I'm doing a 2005 6.0 liter Chevy motor with a 4L60E. And this transfer case, and I'm running a 1-ton differential front and rear. I'm actually working on them, so you can see some video of us hands-on, and I can go through the whole suspension, what we're doing, the process, and describe the parts and stuff like that.
Are you going to spec any vehicles? Are you going to put together any stuff to keep your guys busy and then just sell it as a complete vehicle?
My plans were to do that, but it's just every time we're halfway building a vehicle, we always sell it. Somebody always wants to buy it. They want it that way.
Yeah.
So we never get an opportunity to finish the vehicle. But, I guess we have to kind of keep the vehicle hidden, so nobody sees it. But somebody sees it, they always want to purchase it from us.
Now you got some old Jeep cores, right? Old Willys, flathead four-cylinder stuff.
Yeah, I've got a lot of old Jeeps. Got the old 1940s. I've got a 41. Trying to put together, or it's put together. I'm just trying to restore it, but it's on the back burner. Whenever I get a time.
Do you work on prop vehicles for any of the studios? Have you ever done any of that
stuff?
Matter
of fact, yeah, we've used about 5 or 6 of our Jeeps for Paramount Studios. Actually, they bought them or rented them from us, and they used them for a couple of shoots and stuff like that. And they give them back to us. Sometimes they give them back to us all smashed up or in pieces. But
well, the Vanishing Point, the 70 Challengers, they borrowed 6 of those, and they went back to the dealerships and everything, and that's why they're collectibles now and everything. But even the Vanishing Point cars, you know, basically were borrowed. Yeah.
We've done so many different things. It's unbelievable, you know, the amount of things that we've done here out of the shop, and the amount of people that we've met, and people in different industries that we've helped out. I mean, it's crazy, you know, it's way out, you know, but a lot of people don't know about it.
So before you had this facility, which is packed to the gills, you kept this basically in your personal residence? It just built up over time, and then
I started this business from my driveway.
Did it start to boom when you started to deal with it? I mean, is it still growing? Is it flattening out? More popular? Less popular?
It's always been the same. It's always popular and always will be popular, and I don't think it'll ever die out, because the Jeep is a toy. You know, it's a weekend toy for anybody that has enthusiasm to go off-roading or wheeling or anything, you know? But I mean, it's
even as far as blowing U-joints and stuff, pretty much everybody that's off-road gets dirty and busts their knuckles a little bit though, huh?
Yeah, occasionally. There's some of our customers that don't even know how to check the air pressure on their vehicle or something like that, and we kind of try to teach them the basics of doing.
But those people leave that. I mean, either they don't. If you off-road it, you're gonna basically have to get dirty, and you're gonna have to basically, you know, you're gonna bust U-joints. You're gonna get flat tires and stuff. So
yeah.
you do the now. A lot of people run tubeless tires with those bead locks, but also people do tubes, and then they also do the bladders on the inside so that they can run the really super low pressure.
Yeah,
so
there's a lot of people run a new type of bead lock. It's made by a company called Ston. It's an internal bead lock, and it holds the beads inside. It presses it against the wheel and it holds it in there. But people use bead locks, and the most popular thing is probably just bead lock wheels.
But some people too run really super low for the crawling and stuff, so they can reticulate over the.
Some of the tires that they use are they're coming out with, strictly rock crawling tires now, and they use double bead locks on them, so you can really run them at zero PSI. It's pretty cool.
Yeah. Now, what about the tractor tread thing? Is that mostly a gimmick?
Tractor tread, it's a gimmick.
Because it's horrendously expensive.
Expensive. It's high maintenance. Loud. I think anybody that put tank treads or tractor treads on a vehicle.
Now, what about
doing it to show off or something? You know.
What about the sand rails that run the reverse rotation? They basically run them instead of hanging out the back. They're mid-engine. Do you ever deal with any of that stuff?
We built a couple of vehicles that had mid-engines, and they were used for free running, for Baja courses and stuff like that. We pulled the engine back.
Yeah.
And just to get it a better center gravity and stuff. I always want to go anywhere.
Yeah?
I try to take